Sean, what a win to cap off a fine week.
Yeah, very pleasing. Quite obviously, you know, three wins back-to-back in the Premier League is difficult, as we know, under the circumstances. And, you know, it's hard for me to not mention a very, very strong performance against Man United. And I think we all agree that was another head-scratcher, because we've had a few of them here this season. But overall, I mean, the mentality of the players continues to grow. The qualities that you've got to find to win games, I mean, that's the biggest thing for me. The most pleasing thing is finding different ways to win. I spoke when I got here. I had the group in pre-season. We had a chance to develop it further and offer them the ways that we thought we could win games. And so far this season, I think we've been, it's been on show. We've played games where we've dominated the chance count. We've played games where we've dominated with the ball and some very high quality football. We've had games where we've had to really dig in, as today, and defend properly and defend very hard as a group, be effective from the bench and the squad mentality, and then find quality. And I think they're a really good side. I mean, there's no two ways about it. Chelsea are a very good side. They've got a very good manager. So for them to come here, do you think you're going to dominate every part of the game? Maybe not, but can you dominate the bit that counts? Can you go and win games? That mentality continues to grow.
You touched on it, but and you always say there's no easy game in the Premier League, which there isn't. That three back-to-back for Everton, that, I don't think the club's achieved that for nearly 3 years. Does that just really reiterate how impressive these past few games have been? I know the performances have been all there all season, but results-wise?
Yeah, look, we're in a results industry. You know, I've never hidden from that. You know, good performances, bad performances. At the end of the day, you've got to win games. There's an underbelly of football, which I know because I've been in it all my life, and that's a teamship that can do the extra things that you need to win games. That's beginning to develop here. I've always said it for years. When you're on song and you're playing well, any team in the Premier League can win games. What about the ones when you're not quite as well? What about today? You come across a really high-talented Chelsea group of players. How can you find ways of winning that game? You know, second half, how can you find ways of digging in and making sure you're seeing it through and still find your moments when you have to? And we did. And delighted, you know. A couple of things. Ganner only came off because he's put so much in. He's put so much effort into his recent performances. He just looked tired. Simple as that. Lewis Dobbin, fantastic. Young player coming into the game today. Put him on. It's always a risk. It was hard. Pato was another one. Terrific coming on. But see him score a goal. But the biggest thing, I've told the group, I mean, people laugh at it, but the authenticity of his reaction. Dances and all that nonsense. Not for me, that. Just go and enjoy the moment. And you watch his performance, I mean, his reaction, and you watch the team behind him all go and gravitate towards it. That's when you're on something, in my opinion, because it's real, it's authentic.
What would you put the slower start, shall we say, down to? Do you think it's just the we played a lot of football and tough games as well?
Yeah, I mean, look, it can happen. You know, we're not the real deal, you know. What we're doing is a group of players who are developing. We're not the real deal. You know, we've still got to put the hard yards in and we've still got to learn that you've got to be at it every minute. But they're a good side. You know, they can keep the ball. They can play. You know, sometimes that flattens down the atmosphere. And don't think, well, a minute, that's not part of their game plan, because it would have been. Calm it all down. They know this is becoming a cauldron. They know the Evertonians. They know the Toffees are behind us. They know that connection is growing. They'll do their homework. Make no mistake like we do. So they'll have said all of them things. For us to come out of that spell, for us to find the key moments we did, and then to dig in and grind out, and so many key performers. I mean, Mika, what a player he's turning into. You know what I mean? Seeing these players develop is so pleasing. Beyond results, you've got to get results. That's my job. But seeing players develop is what I started coaching for, to offer them something more than I had as a player, or more than I thought I had as a player. See these guys developing right in front of your eyes. That, beyond everything, for me, is really, really pleasing. And, of course, like I say, winning games, of course.
Mika was arguably being one of the players of the season so far. He recently revealed to us that he was carrying a little bit of a knock for a long time. He's obviously had that sorted now with the help of you and your staff. We're seeing the benefit to that, aren't we, in terms of his performances?
He's not renowned for a million words, Miko, trust me. So, you know, getting some information out of him and trying to get him to share and just chat with you can be interesting. But he's resilient, he's growing, his physical presence is growing, his understanding of the Premier League. All of it, you know, but not just him. I mean, Jimmy Garner had 2 days of sickness. To come out and deliver that as a team player, these are things that fans do notice. I think to be fair, the Evertonians do notice, but as managers and coaches and your teammates, they notice all of this stuff. People are doing all of the hard bits of football, you know what I mean? That's so important in football. I know we've got quality and we can still play better, but sometimes you've got to credit the opposition. They're a group of highly talented footballers. Not easy to dominate them games with the ball, let alone without it. But you've got to find ways. And that, for me, is the most pleasing thing, finding different ways to win football matches.
And 3 clean sheets to go with those wins as well.
Yeah, I mean, that, as you can imagine, that's absolutely delightful for us, because at the end, let's say that's been a challenge amongst many others in the last few years for Everton. Everton Football Club, and we are beginning to correct it. Like I said, I'm so delighted today for everyone around the club and everyone concerned, fans, players alike. But the reason why I don't go running around the stadium is because we're on 14 points. That's the reality. Yes, marvellous run of games. All season I've been very pleased with how things have gone and going. But we're on 14 points. There's a lot of work to be done.
Just on Dobbin, we've already briefly spoke about him, but I guess he's had to be quite patient, hasn't he, this season? He put in a good pre-season. But I take it he's been doing the stuff right behind the scenes for you to give him this opportunity, and he's took it today, hasn't he?
I mentioned to the group afterwards in the dressing rooms that the players behind the starting 11 or the regular start 11 currently, that's often the strength of a group. They've been outstanding, and I've just told them that. The way they're training, because obviously when players are playing regularly, they do less, the other players do more. The way that the levels they've been pushing and demanding, I mean, that is the strength of a group. But when you need it, part of come on today was excellent in a very tough game to come into. Dobbo's part of that group, of course. Many others. Ben Godfrey, has been fantastic the way he's going about it. Keno, you know, these are players who are having to wait, they're having to be patient, but they've got to stay right. And if you stay right and you look after yourself, when you're needed, you get your rewards, and it makes sure the group look after themselves. So I couldn't be more proud of the group who are not currently the ones that you figure every week. And Dobbo's part of that, and he gets a goal. I'm so pleased for him, absolutely so pleased for him.
Finally, it's obviously a really busy festive period. We've had a lot of games coming up to now, and then we've got a lot more on the horizon. How nice will it be to have a full week ahead of that trip to Burnley, which I guess maybe has a little bit more value to you, having spent so long there?
No, it doesn't have any more value for me. I've mentioned it many times. All the ex-clubs I've played against when I was a player, coached against, managed against, I had a fantastic time here. That will never change. I'm Everton's manager. That currently won't be changing. So therefore, I'll be going there just to get a win.
And having those extra days this week without a game in midweek, that's a big thing as well.
Yeah, just give the players a break. They will get a couple of down days, make sure they're recovering. But the fixture list is what it is. I always said to players, that's where it's at. That's the demands, that's the challenge, that's what we're going to do. End of.
Thank you, Sean.
Thanks.